Coffey dressed tonight for Pittsburgh. Denardi and Dahlquist start on the defense for Minnesota. Up front for Pittsburgh, Lemieux, Recchi, and Bork. And this is Paul Stanton, number 22. Samuelson is 5. He got the puck out. Pittsburgh on the move. Good pass. Stanton shot. A first save of the game by Casey. This is Gagne. He has Madonna and Brian Propp with him. In over the line, and the shot kicked out by Barrasso. Center right in front of the net. Madonna left on, checked in there, but the puck off his stick. Another shot, and that's blocked by Barrasso. Into the side of the net. Well, he's starting on a great pace here tonight in game two. Puck cleared across the line. Recchi and Lemieux. And Madonna got back for Minnesota and brings it back up again. In over the line. Right to the net he goes. Literally into the net. He ran into the goalpost. And he is hurt.
And there's a penalty coming on the play as well. If I read Van Helleman's signal correctly. And we've had quite a start to this game, Harry. Minute and 7 seconds. There have been a couple of pretty good chances. A good shot by Stanton. The play at the net right here. Good well, omen, maybe.
The anthem singer kept the crowd alive. That was a nice change.
Already 3 shots, 2 of them by the visitors.
Hockey game.
Well, the power play for Minnesota is on there now, early in game two. Gagne moves it to the left side. Propp dropped it off. Denardi got it back, and Denardi again in around the net. Gagne was out front. Denardi hangs onto it. Side of the net with the pass. Gagne coming in. They ram away at it. And the Penguins clear down the ice. The net again is off the magnets behind Tom Barrasso.
Andy Van Helleman has decided that Dave Gagne knocked it off, so the faceoff will go outside. That really hurt Pittsburgh, Dick, because they had iced the puck. And now they're going to have a faceoff in the neutral zone instead of having the North Stars bring the puck all the way up. In game one, the power play for neither team was very successful, and especially that 0-for-2 with two men up for Pittsburgh. And you can see the North Stars power play that's been so good to them was very ineffective in game one, and they won anyway.
Roberts and Taglianetti, the defenseman for Pittsburgh. Taglianetti will come back. Erie and Lemieux, the penalty killers up front. Minnesota, power play, and they have the puck deep in the zone. Out front, and Barrasso had to cover on the short side smartly. Kept in up the line. Lemieux missed it. Stanton fired it on the boards. It got off the skate and out. Erie ran into his man, Broughton, and knocked him down. Denardi lost the helmet. Stays with the puck and goes back to his own line with it. Now he loses it. And it's shot by Erie down the ice. 55 seconds left on the power play. Minnesota looking for the first goal of the game. Broughton, he's in, and another strong effort by Broughton. It is centered. And again, Pittsburgh with a chance to clear it to a one. Gillen. Mullen. Gillen. Can't get the shot by Casey, who was down. Pittsburgh fired up here, killing this penalty. Nearly pick up a shorthanded goal. What a great chance. 25 seconds left of the penalty.
Harry, seems there's more intensity already in the first couple of minutes of this one than we had in 62 nights ago.
Oh, I think we're in for a dandy tonight. The way these two teams have started, plenty of good chances, some good hits already, and the teams look like they're upset with each other. Some good body checks right there. Erie on, Taglianetti on Bellows. And here's the 2-on-1 as they get the puck past Broughton. And Joe Mullen shoots it, but it's very well played by Denardi. Look how far out Casey was. knowing Tenorti wasn't going to allow the pass across. They were kind of lucky to get the rebound before the Pittsburgh player flipped into the net. It would have been a shorthanded goal. We saw two of those in game one, one each.
Gillen played a strong game six against Boston. Dressed for the first time in the final. He's number 15. And he wins this faceoff. Penguins shoot it down the ice. 20 seconds remaining in that penalty.
Another reason for Gillen, Bob, not only is penalty killing, he's their best faceoff man, and they felt they were beaten in that department in game one.
Minnesota have to move it quickly. Only 8 seconds left in the penalty. Glenn shot it in. Wide to the right side, into the corner. Out it comes again, Madonna. Nearly lost it to Mario Lemieux. Penalty is over. It's shot down the ice. The goaltender, Casey, had to play it. This is Glenn again. On the boards to the line. Minnesota trying to move it in. Dolan chased it and overskated the puck. 3.5 minutes into the first period. No score. Crowd alive. Much better pace to start game two. Funny hop. Him off the boards. On a strange angle and right in front of the net. Barrasso scooped it up. And he held it. Teams are at full strength now. Roberts goes back to the net. Stopped at the line, but now Roberts gets going again. In on the right side is Recchi. Stevens in front of the net. And it bounces off his skate and got back to the line again. Gavin in with a shot, and he missed. Side of the net. Cleared by Francis to the line, kept in by Minnesota. Barrasso stepping out of the goal. He saw Bobby Smith skating for it behind the net. Here's Murphy moving to center. Up for Francis, that was too far. Coming up to the 5-minute mark, and Smith. He's been deadly in the playoffs for Minnesota. Two game-winning goals in a row for the North Stars. Stevens can't handle it. Bureau moving to center and up over the Pittsburgh line. Ran into his own man. Berezan shook it off, though, and got it back to Bureau. He comes in the slot area. Forced back by Trottier. Looney got it ahead. Recchi to the right wing. Trottier was in there, and he went by it. Bureau turns back for Minnesota. Berezan didn't see it. Casey stopping one and rolling it off to the left wing. Minnesota moving out now. No score in the first period. Barrasan goes in. Pulled the defenseman Samuelson over with him. Good body contact in the early going of this game. Here's Jagr finding a hole. He got up as far as the line and was poke-checked. Now he has to come back and try to recover. But it's Gavin in. Sharp angle shot. Jagr could clear it. The net off the magnets again, and it came down on top of Barrasso. He was in the crease, and, well, you see the net right down on his back. Shots are 5-3 already in favor of Minnesota. No score, though, in the first period. Samuelson up with Lemieux back to Samuelson. On the short side, the save made by Casey. Tenorti moving the puck ahead for Minnesota. Shot into the zone. Barrasso being careful again. Stanton moved it up there. Got it in on the left wing. And Tenorti was back again in front of his own net. Got it on the right side, a little bit too far. Johnson couldn't handle it. Now Johnson moving up. He's hauled down. Madonna at the blue line. Knocked down as he tried to go in. He goes right on, and the Penguins move it in. Lemieux chasing it back for the goal at the line. Robert shot 3 feet wide. Cullen was given a hard shot in front of the net. 6.5 minutes into the opening period. Dropped back by Gagner, and now here's Murphy. Up with Lemieux, centered it! His knife toward the net, and Casey had it taped. Gagne trying to get it out. Roberts back up again. Lemieux was near the line. He didn't see him. Casey likes to come out once in a while. Didn't have to play at that time. Coming up to the 8-minute mark. No score. Medano trying to drop it. Broken up. Kept in now. Roberts to the right side of Mullen. Francis trying to get away. Stevens on the left wing, out of his reach. Gagne comes back, bumps his man off the puck. Lost Francis. Backhander stopped by Casey. Casey out of the net, scooped it away toward the board. Jim Pott, number two, his first shift, takes it at center. Backhands it in. He was nailed seconds before. He's going off now. Pott, number two for Pittsburgh. Minnesota moving in. Bobby Smith again, a backhand shot off the blocker of Barrasso. 8 minutes gone and a hectic first period. The play call bellows a hurt outside the line. 6-5 of the shots in favor of the North Stars.
Brian bellows, the North Stars are livid with Andy Van Helleman saying that all Samuelson need Brian bellows. We went through this in the Edmonton series with Craig Muni.
And we went
to a very similar hit, Dick.
Boston series two with Neely. And that's it. That's the same position almost, Harry. If you replay the Neely play, Samuelson is in exactly the same position when he makes contact with the other player.
Well, there's no penalty on the play, but Bellows is hurt.
And Paul Coffey is on the ice warming up.
Usually on the stick of the guy that he's trying to get the puck to.
Chambers shot it in. Barrasso stopped it behind the net. Bureau was over there anticipating that play. Now Barrasso knocked one down. It's still in front of the net. Cleared into the corner, and Jim Pock tried to move it out. Got it up on the left side, and Trottier won't get there. Glenn got back. But it's stopped by Erie. He was bumped by Glenn and went flying. Erie again trying to keep it in. Pock slapped it toward the net. The North Stars covering up and get it out to center ice. Moving in. Chambers drive high. And here's Trottier looking for some room. He had to back off. Now Jágr's shot. Casey made a fine stop on that drive by Jágr. Jágr has it again. On the board. And he usually comes up with it. Took a hit this time for his effort, though. Samuelson giving a bump outside the line by Berezan. Now Berezan is hit by Samuelson. Erie came over and hit Berezan. Penalty going to be called by Andy Van Helleman as Kevin Collins grabs Tagliamenti and Samuelson.
Well, Samuelson's going to be the target all night after that hit on Bellows. Although this didn't involve Samuelson at the end, it did at the start as he rattled the North Star right into the bench. So Samuelson's going to have to keep that visor clean because the green-shirted guys are going to be after him.
No score. 9-0 gone in the first. Face-off just outside the Pittsburgh line. Gillen won it. Shut down the ice by Stanton. Tenorti and Bronten are coming back. Bellows is out there now for Minnesota. Gagne skating with him, and Brian Kopp is the other forward. Gagne had to shoot it in quickly, and Barrasso stepped out. Just bedded on the boards in the corner, and it goes high into the crowd, but in the glass first, and went out.
Well, this period almost half over, and the Doctor's power play only permission for Paul Coffey is holding up. He has yet to make an appearance. The Penguins haven't had a power play, so Tom Barrasso hasn't had to look at number 77 ahead of him. A lot of pressure on Barrasso here tonight, I think, Harry. He took some heat, but, you know, the goalies, it's that time of year, I suppose. Joe Malosh, who's the goaltender coach for Pittsburgh, told me tonight that he agrees without question they have to get better goaltending than what Barrasso gave them in game one. When you're in a Stanley Cup final series.
Well, he's looked sharper to me tonight than he did at any time in game one. The shots are 6-6. Both goalies have had about two difficult stops to make. A lot of animosity showing up. And whenever the players dislike each other, there's Joe Malosh sitting between the strength coach and the cerebral coach, Scotty Bowman, there on Malosh's right.
Gillen, 15 on this faceoff again. He has been killing penalties for Pittsburgh in the playoffs very well. Mullen lost a chance to move it out. Slapped back to the net. Samuelson took his man heavily in on the boards. That was Propp. He's without the helmet now. And Stanton hit him this time. Stars keep it in to Nordy's. Quick pass to Gagne. Gagne trying to find a better spot for his shot. Maybe this is it. Here it comes, and he missed the far post. Tenorti stopping it at the point. Slapped it in front. Propp was covered by Samuelson. And the Penguins shoot it down the ice. 1 minute left in the penalty. Power play Minnesota moving to center. Propp. And he left it for Gagne. Back to Propp. Dropped it back neatly. And a high shot. Loved by Barrasso. And he decides to shoot it himself. Pretty good shot high in the air all the way down the ice. 9:30 left in the period. 35 seconds on this power play. And the North Stars are moving in. Broken up at the line. And cleared again as Dahlin couldn't handle the pass. Chambers back. 25 seconds to go on this power play. Bobby Smith. Boy, is he skating well. Moving across center. Grabbed from behind by Mullen. And the Penguins are killing this penalty in fine style. Chambers turning it on again. Coming away from Mullen. In over the Pittsburgh line and dropped it back. Bobby Smith looking back to the point. Pass comes back there now. Penalty is over. Medano in the corner, centered it. Here's a shot picked up by Barrasso. Big stop by Tom Barrasso. Boy, he covered across in front of the net in a hurry. Puck over the glass, into the crowd. Teams are at full strength. 8:38 left for the period. No score.
On a shot that should have been a difficult one for Tom Barrasso.
Minnesota moving the puck again as Stu Gavin. Bump hard in the corner. Stevens hit him. It's in front of the net. Backhand shot stop. And Barrasso diving. Knocked it away with a stick. Broughton trying to center. And he comes out front. Can't jam it by Barrasso. And it's moved out by Murphy. Recky skates in over the line. Recky dropped it back. Here's a shot that's off the stick. And Recky has the rebound. Tried to stuff it in. And Casey covered against the post. On the short side, on a Recky's effort.
Bob Johnson said today that he sensed in game one his team wasn't ready. The day of the game, in the dressing room before the game. I'm sure he didn't have the same feeling tonight, Harry. It's a totally different atmosphere to the Pittsburgh Hockey Club.
There sure is, and Recky's one of the guys that's showing a lot more dash. His own evaluation of his game one performance was short to the point. He said, I stunk. It's that simple. Looks like he's had a shower and smells a lot better tonight to me.
Well, that's refreshing, if I could use that word, to hear a hockey player say that without a list of excuses stretching from armpit to hand.
Francis now with Recky and Stevens. Roberts and Murphy, the Pittsburgh defenseman, up of the line. 8:05 left of the period. Francis winning the draw, but bumped by Smith as he tried to go after it and fell. Doherty moved it ahead. Dahlin trying to get it out. Put it up to Bobby Smith. He made a pretty good move at center before taking a shot. Barrasso, easy save. Murphy running into traffic behind his own goal. Murphy again had to move. Bellows is in there to bump him. Penguins can't get it out. It's Murphy third time, and he does succeed. Slapped ahead, hit the linesman. Kevin Collins allowing Murphy to move up. Recky is upended, trying to go in. Tenorti hit him and knocked him flying. 7:20 left in the period, and no score yet. Here's Recky. Shot it in. Tenorti missed him with a hit this time, and Tenorti went flying into the boards. Samuelson shot one in there. Recky is nailed inside the line. Pass up over the line in front. Propp hands it off. Medano waited too long. Smith pass. Penalty coming up against Pittsburgh as they pick it up. The penalty is called, and Tronche is looking for somebody. 6:54 left in the period. Another Minnesota power play. 6:54 to play in the period, and another Minnesota power play. Bobby Smith will take the draw against Gillen and won it. Back to the line. Chambers faked the shot. He has Glenn on the other side, and now his shot is off the leg. Mullen blocked it effectively, and it went all the way down the ice. Mullen going after it in there against big Brian Glenn. Chambers comes out. And the North Stars shoot it in. Barrasso again out of the net. Into the corner. Dahlin is checked by Stanton. Bobby Smith has it for Minnesota. To Madonna. Other side. It's Chambers' shot. Smith was parked in front of the net. And it's up over the glass into the crowd.
Well, Bobby Smith with four game-winning goals here in the 91 playoffs, one short of the record held by Bossy and Curry. Smith is living proof that experience is not what happens to a player, it's what a player does with what happens to him. And Smith has shown that that experience has really come in handy for his North Stars. There's the chance by Smith that went up over the glass. Out of the rink, I don't know whether it was Smith who deflected it, didn't get enough of it, or perhaps Barrasso deflected it over. It was Smith because the faceoff is outside.
Broughton tries a long shot in on the glass that gives Pittsburgh a chance to clear it. Lemieux moving up onto Nordy. Nearly picked it off on that cross ice pass to Broughton. Broughton comes back out. Left side, and it's broken up, cleared again, down to the center ice area. 5:45 left of the period. 50 seconds in the penalty. Stanton trying to send the North Stars back. Here he moves in. The view offended in front of the net. Pittsburgh gets the goal. 1-0.
Well, Bob Erie scores a shorthanded goal. Lemieux, I don't know whether he'll get an assist, but he should. He drew a penalty and tied up the one North Star that might have been able to get out. Dave Gagne and Scott Erie, who walked out of the corner. So Lemieux can hurt you all kinds of ways. Here's one time he hurts you without ever handling the puck. He draws a penalty here. Right here. That was the penalty on Gagne that Van Helleman had called. And then he interferes with Gagne so he can't get up to check Erie, who walked out of the corner to give the Pens a 1-0 lead.
Short-handed goal. Taglianetti got the assist. Erie the goal. 14:26 the time. 1-0 Pittsburgh. And what a big goal that is. Minnesota unable to get their power play going and right here give up a goal while on a power play. And 20 seconds left in the Pittsburgh penalty.
Well, there's Bellows out there against Samuelson. Remember the collision in center ice? Bellows was incensed. It was a knee, and he was very fortunate, Dick. He didn't get a penalty as he punched Samuelson in the back of the helmet when he went down.
We have been retaliation about 10 minutes later. Bob Erie's been a very handy guy for this hockey team in the playoff, Barry. And in the last series, he made some good hits, a much publicized hit on Raymond Bork of the Bruins, and he gets a dandy one here. Good shot, sharp angle. Top shelf, short side.
A great decision to hang on to the puck and be patient with it, because he wouldn't have had much chance to score if he shot it when he first got it.
Bellows back to the net. Kropp was hit in the corner. Now he's loose to make a play. Bellows trying to shake off Samuelson. Puck comes out front. Quick shot into a crowd. Gagne, another try. And here's another shot kicked away by Barrasso. And a penalty coming up. Going to be against Pittsburgh. Another Penguin penalty. Crowd getting restless, but they're leading here 1-0.
One team gets four and the other team gets none.
Minnesota again, every man up, trying to win the draw, and they fail in that attempt. So Pittsburgh shoots it down the ice. We have 4:40 left in the period, and 1:50 in the penalty. 1-0 Pittsburgh. The goal by Erie from Taglianetti at 14:26. Barrasso out. Perry got it to the line, but not over it. Dallin, he's bumped, waited too long. Bobby Smith going in there. Smith poked it into the corner. Lemieux trying to tie him up, and does. Dallin again digs it out from the corner. Looking in front of the net, the pass intended for Smith. He'll get another shot at it. Paglianetti doing a great job on him. Dumped behind the net by Lemieux, and again the Penguins are going to shoot it out to Lemieux. One man back, Gary catching up. Lemieux coming in with a shot. He was knocked down as he let that one go, and the fans wanted a penalty call against the North Stars. They don't get it. Mullen couldn't clear it. Mullen again, up for Gillen. One man back, Mullen and Gillen. Here's Gillen, ripped a hard shot, missed. 40 seconds remaining on this power play. Mullen again, upended, and this time there'll be a Minnesota penalty. Kropp takes the puck, and the play is called. 1-0 Pittsburgh, 3:24 left in the period. And it's a Minnesota penalty for the first time in the period.
I think with 36 seconds left in the Samuelson penalty. Boy, there was one time there, where just as the North Stars cleared the puck into the Pittsburgh zone, Mario Lemieux drilled Mike Modano. There's the penalty call on Bellis.
You could have bet the mortgage that the Minnesota North Stars were going to get the next penalty. It was just a question of when.
Number 23, Brian Bellows, 2 minutes for hooking.
They'll have a hook on Bellows. They'll play five aside. And then Pittsburgh will get their first chance.
16-36.
Now here's the Modano play. He clears the puck into the middle. Now watch the view. He drills him just off the stanchion here along by the boards. Look out, Mike. You're going to hit it dead on right there. Mario do that too often.
Good. Mario's got to do more of that to show his teammates that he really cares about this one, and he's going to go out of his way and out of his character to prove it, not only to his teammates, but to the North Stars.
Rucky on the draw, wins it. Stevens. And then along the boards by Bureau. Stevens gets loose. He was given a bump, but kept going as Dahlquist hit him. Dahlquist gets the puck for Minnesota. Stevens takes him out of the play. Penguins trying to keep it in. Can't do it. By the way, Coffey is not on. He hasn't been on there yet for Pittsburgh. On the bench. He's coming on the ice. Coffey, 77, gets a big cheer. Stevens shot right on. Casey made the save. Now let's see how Paul Coffey does. He's coming back. Listen to the crowd as Coffey picks it up. Is this something? Coffey skating beautifully. What else is new? Recky takes it in. Recky trying to center it. Coffey trying to cure the Pittsburgh power play. Listen. Coffey again, moving the puck well. Jagr. Here's Francis. Gloved by Casey. He saw that one all the way, and it'll be tough to beat him from that distance.
A very poor percentage shot by Francis. There's Paul Coffey with the special helmet and protective device over the jaw. Steve Latton, the equipment manager for the Pittsburgh Penguins, worked long and hard to get one that Coffey could wear and see as well as breathe and with as little discomfort as possible. So he's certainly given his team an emotional lift. They are playing with the purpose tonight that we did not see them play with in game one, and deserve to be up 1-0, despite the fact they killed penalties almost the entire first period.
43 seconds left for the penalty. To Bellows. Francis on the draw. Coffey is parked at the blue line near the boards. And Bork is to his right. Puck dropped in by Brossacker. Tenorti, chance to move it. Does not right away, but Gavin, I'm sure, will. And he slaps it to center ice. 30 seconds remaining on the power play. Francis trying to drop it for Jagr. Doesn't. Again, Jagr digs it out. Into the corner with it and back to the line. Lemieux and Coffey. Lemieux to Coffey. Coffey winds up. Lemieux. Back The coffee shot. Rebound. Lemieux. Oh, what a great save by Casey. Lemieux jumped on it very quickly and had that short side, he thought. Lemieux again, rightfully won. That block, the penalty is over. And there's the penalized player on the ice chasing it. Like coffee got there. Bill Bork. Coffee bumping Smith. Coffee shoots it to center. Hard hit at center ice, but there'll be a penalty against Minnesota. Recky was upended at center ice.
Chambers did the upending. I'm sure it will be he who gets the penalty, and Krejci comes over and talks to him. Again, I repeat, what a different atmosphere in this building, and especially on the ice, compared to the game the other night, game one. Here's that stop by Casey right here.
Boy, he's quick. He's down, right, he's up, he's over, and makes a nice stop. Bellows took an out-of-the-way run at Coffey. Now, Coffey was playing illegally here because they were not on the power play, and the doctor wanted him off. But Bellows, he says, I don't care whether it's Coffey or your jaw's broken. I'm taking you out with a legal hit. And, of course, this is what occurred at center for the penalty as Chambers sent Recky through the air with a knee or a trip or however Andy Van Helleman called it.
All that interference, he had not touched the puck, so there's Chambers, and the Jaws music arrives again on the power play.
Well, this game is about 1,000% better than the other. One of the reasons is these teams don't like each other now. It took a little long to get that way.
Left of the period. The only scoring play, a shorthanded goal by Bob Airy. 14:26, 1-0 Pittsburgh. Power play, Penguins. Coffey on the ice again. On the power play, Recky on the faceoff. One of Coffey at the line into the final minute of the period. Murphy played it in. Back to Murphy. His shot in front of the net. Lemieux. Score!
It's a great play here on a puck that's tough to control to get it over at the last minute to Stevens. He picked it out of the air. Stevens made an equally nice play by kicking it up to his stick. Here's a better look at it with our reverse angle viewpoint. There's the play. Stevens, and then back off the skate and in, as Lemieux knew that Casey had no chance of getting back after taking the initial pass from Stevens. The power play goal, 2-0, 45 seconds to go in period one.
Stevens, Murphy assisted on the goal. Or Stevens got the goal. Mario and Larry Murphy assisted at 19:10. Power play goal for Pittsburgh. 2-0, only 25 seconds left in the period. Minnesota with a chance moving in. Off the board. Stevens looking for it. Can't find it. Clear to center ice, and here's Mullen. One man back there. And Mullen is stopped. They rough it up a bit. Mullen knocked down. From the line. Drive is grabbed by Casey. As Roberts quickly shot it with time running out. And the period ends.
Well, that's the best period by a long shot in this series. We're going to see some great hockey played. I know there was a lot of people worried about whether this series would be worthy as a final. If that's an indication, we're going to see a dandy here.
Pittsburgh penalized for too many men on the ice. So once again, a power play. Minnesota, 2-0 is the score. Pittsburgh leading. The Stars shoot it in. That is Gagne 15, and here's Propp. Propp gets it back to the line. Bernardi's shot deflected wide. Shot on the glass by Samuelson and out. Broughton starts the play again. Up to center ice. Broughton to the line. Hang on to it. Goes in for his shot. That hit a stick. Pittsburgh covering up fairly well. Killing another penalty. Lemieux this time shoots it right on the net. 1:15 left in the power play. Chambers trying to hit Madonna. He took the pass off the boards and goes in. A nice save by the score. Barrasso stopped it, but somehow it bounced in front and in.
Well, Madonna just blew past Gordy Roberts as the North Stars score their 33rd power play goal in the playoffs, a new NHL record formerly held by Edmonton. And this star, Madonna, who hasn't done much in this series, gets outside Gordy Roberts right there. The first shot is stopped by Barrasso, but the rebound goes right to Madonna, and Barrasso's out of position. And Madonna, at a bad angle, puts it in. Barrasso probably gave up a little bit of a rebound. It was too fat, and Madonna had a little luck in that it came right back to him while Barrasso was down.
Power play goal by Madonna from Chambers, and the goaltender, Casey, drew an assist. So a great start to the second period for Minnesota. Dolan went in and washed the puck off his stick. Loney trying to bring it out. Smith stopped him. The help of Madonna on the boards. Madonna trying to get it loose again. It goes in to Dolan, back to the net. Madonna comes in to help. This is Francis clearing it out. All the way down inside the Minnesota line is Stevens. Casey out of the net. And a scramble to get back in. And ran into Glenn as defenseman. No harm done, though. Murphy comes back. Larry Murphy up to the line and getting to center. Murphy allowed to come in. Took a shot. Easy save for Casey. Lemieux put it into the corner. Loney trying to get it back to him. He is stopped in there. Loney trying to get loose. Does. Three Minnesota players were there. And they get it to the line. And out. Slapped back in by Murphy. And that is offside.
Turn to page 38.
2:06 into the period. North Stars have scored. Madonna, 55 seconds. It's 2-1 Pittsburgh.
Disquieting effect on this crowd and on the Penguins, who really played with a lot of jump in the first period. We'll soon see whether that makes much difference or not.
Finally got a power play goal. So they're down by one now. Murphy takes it at center. That one will go high into the crowd. Game two, how big? If you believe in history, very big. Since the final was made a best of seven, the team winning game two went on to win the Cup 38 of 52 times. Now that's a mark of 73%. I'm sure Craig Patrick and company is thinking about that.
That's the Penguins official box for Kehoe. A playoff record Mario broke this year, assistant coach besides Craig Patrick.
Here's a chance coming in. Broughton can't center it, though. He was covered very quickly by Gord Murphy. Puck into the center ice zone. Tenorti trying to shake loose. Does. And pounds the puck back in. 2-1. Pittsburgh leading. Nearing the 3-minute mark, and they're in again. Barrasso covered up and hit the outside of the net. Nearly got in on the short side. Retty hemmed in. Can't get the puck out. Brian Glenn lost it. Lemieux can't catch up to it. He was racing in there with Phil Bork. And here's Bork with the puck. Into Recky in the far corner. Recky left it along the boards, picked it up again, and shot it back to the goal. Bork bumped by Glenn. Lemieux around the net, tried to stuff it in. Now he centers it. And three North Stars get out of the zone, led by Gavin. Through the middle, Gavin right side. Now Gavin gets in front of the net. He went Duchesne turning around. Bureau tried to get it back in front. He was stopped in the corner. Stanton brings it ahead. And it's shot in on the net by Phil Bork. Lemieux upended again, trying to go in. So this will be offside. He couldn't clear the zone. Pittsburgh leads 2-1. Nearing the 4-minute mark of the second period. Minnesota winning the first game, 5-4. Pittsburgh trying to even the series. They have now lost home ice advantage to Minnesota. Games 3 and 4. Up north. North Stars bring it in. The play by Wilkinson doesn't work. Madonna went in there to bump his man behind the net. Krejci tried to get it loose. Slides up along the boards and out. Jágr is stopped near center. Following the play was Samuelsson to shoot it in. Pittsburgh changing as the play moves out. Right wing pass, and it's Gagné having trouble controlling it. Put it right under the stick of Taglianetti. Gagné again back at his own blue line. Up through center. Minnesota moving it in. Wilkinson. Weak shot in wide of the goal. Ryan Trottier. His pass. Taglianetti through center. That didn't work. Broken up at the line again by Taglianetti. Right wing pass. Stevens dropped it back. Loney is covered and can't get a shot. Puck played ahead to Smale. He couldn't get too far. And now in across the line. Francis is upended and Minnesota moving down ice. Euro shot off the arm of Barrasso and over the glass. The crowd calling for another penalty against the North Stars. But they're at full strength at this moment. 2-1 Pittsburgh.
Mark Bureau joining the North Stars out of the Calgary organization in March. Harry, you pointed out the other night, we hadn't seen him, Bob and I, until the first game, but he's a handy little guy for this team right about now. He could shoot a puck. He got a big goal the other night with a terrific shot. That was a pretty good one, too, off the arm of Barrasso.
Well, when they play him in the future with the North Stars, if they survive the San Jose trek, with better offensive wingers, he'll score some points in this league as well. Before he got here from Salt Lake City, he was a point-producing center. Bob Gainey's turn, giving him another role here, and he's grabbed it with both hands and done a nice job.
Bobby Smith for Minnesota. Passing out directions as he bends in against Ron Francis. That was Stevens, a little bit anxious, skating inside the circle. Now he's ready. Roberts dumped it behind the net for Murphy. Murphy lugs the puck out to center ice and shoots it into the Minnesota zone. Francis throws one. Got it high, though. And the play called.
Well, Francis walked into a shot that came off an attempted shoot-in that hit the Minnesota defenseman in the hands and came right down to Ron Francis. They're now arguing about where the face-off. Here's the play right here. You can see it went off the Minnesota player's stick. And so the face-off, it should be inside at the place that hit the stick. That's what Francis is arguing about right now. But he's not going to win this argument, and the face-off is coming outside.
Pittsburgh 2, Minnesota 1. 5:24 into the second period. Long shot for Casey. He didn't have to play it. Missed the net. Here's Stevens again. Dropped it back, and Bobby Smith saw that play and just skated with it and knocked it to center ice. Chambers moved it up. Dolan stopped inside the line, but here's Bellows. And now Dolan. Dolan couldn't make a play. Second attempt, he got it into Smith. Turning with it. Smith, unmolested, dropped it neatly. Johnson couldn't get the backhander toward the net. Minnesota pressing again. Finally, it is cleared out by Mullen. Up to center to Stevens. Now he can skate, but he didn't get much room that time, and the shot was deflected over the glass into the crowd. 13:51 left in the second period.
This was kind of popular.
From the faceoff inside the Minnesota line. Stars trying to control. Gavin fell. Jágr picked it up. He's hauled down. Penalty coming up against Minnesota. Gavin thought he might skate away, but he heard the whistle, and he knows exactly what's happening. Duchesne is going off. And here's the faceoff. Gavin got it back quickly. The North Stars are going to clear it. Tenorti decides to kill a few more seconds before shooting it away. Gavin now jumping in the clear. He's in. Heck, had the shot by Barrasso, though. What a close call that was. And wait a minute. A penalty being called against Pittsburgh as Gavin was going in. It's a hooking call against Murphy.
What a break the North Stars got. Attempted shoot-in hit Gord Grossiker in the back and came right to Gavin. And it caught the Pittsburgh Penguins there. You see it goes off Grossiker. Gavin gets it with all the Penguins going the wrong way. And there's the hook right there. So that power play didn't last very long, 15 seconds. Murphy, if there's such a thing as a good penalty, I think that probably was it. There's Bob Johnson. We're talking to Gardner, his assistant coach, is talking to Kehoe upstairs and probably explaining how that happened. You got the worst seat in the rink when you're behind the bench in this profession.
Now they're five aside. And Glimp. Wrap one in on the boards in the corner. Pittsburgh moving it. The pass to Lemieux near his own line. He hands it off. In comes Recchi. Quick shot off a leg. Recchi tried to poke it in front. Lemieux did. Got it back to the blue line. Stanton tried to set it up. Recchi didn't see it. And the North Stars bring it back out, led by Madonna. He's going in. Madonna falls. Smith is looking for it. Dump back to the line. Here's the shot from there. Right in front of the net. Rassel left uncovered for a split second. That's all McDonough needed, but he was upended. As quickly the Penguins cover up. That's Recchi trying to knock it away from Bobby Smith. Smith won it. Got it back. Tenorti moved up. Couldn't get a shot. Here's one. That was rifled by McDonough. Stanton thought he had a check. Mario Lemieux coming out. Lemieux up over the line, going in, great moves. Casey shot out the right skate and saved it. Samuelson kept it in. Lemieux back of the net. Tenorti upended. And Gagne couldn't clear it. Now Chambers moving up to center ice. He's in over the line. Chambers is knocked down. Samuelson got back against Gagne. They go to the ice together. Baglianetti has to go back for it. The pass to the blue line. Stevens skating in. Little bit of room on Tenorti, and the shot missed. Kept in. Stanton centered it. Nobody on that right side, and the Stars get it out. Tenorti on the rush now. This is Gagne, but it's broken up. And Stevens turns. 3 seconds left in the Pittsburgh penalty. And now they're all at full strength. 2-1, Pittsburgh. Gagne coming in there with Wilkinson. The shot picked out. Bellows drives one across in front of the net. Again in for Bellows. Great save by Barrasso. Bellows thought he had one. And Barrasso came up big that time. Roberts hands it off. It was tipped in. Nearing the halfway mark of the second. Pache hit his man. Erie hit his man. Jager comes back and picks it up. Yes, but back up against Dolan. Penguins move it out. Pache skates to the line. Moved it in front of the net. Erie is knocked down before he could get a shot. Jager cut to Erie down again. But a penalty call this time on Bobby Smith. Interference will be the call.
Well, you knew we were going to have a penalty. The game was getting too good. Here's a power play from the Penguins. They need to get something done, Dick. They've lost the momentum to some degree.
Jager moving in on the puck, but not in time. It was cleared down the ice. Pittsburgh 2, Minnesota 1. 10:20 left in the second period. And advantage, Coffey. Lost it. Couldn't handle it. Of course, you expect the timing to be a bit off. Not skating every day.
Coffey got hurt on that rush. He got hit in the jaw. It doesn't look like he's in real pain, but he came right off.
Pittsburgh can't get across that Minnesota line. Gavin dropped it back. It's Tenorti coming out. Got it off the boards and down the ice it goes. Murphy around the net. They have Lindman near Casey yet on this power play. Murphy put the high one over the glass. Faceoff will be out in the center ice area.
Paul Coffey has just come back on the ice. And he seems to be holding Harry at the area of his chest, his stomach. He might have had the wind knocked out of him for just a bit. I was kind of under the impression that Stuart Gavin almost backed off just a bit. I mean, they weren't involved where the puck was. I don't think the collision in it was strictly accidental there. Coffey loses the puck.
Oh, he got hit with a puck, perhaps, because the collision looks fairly harmless.
He didn't back off, but he got the shoulder into the midsection. Like that's it.
So he came right off there, and he was adjusting his mask. That's where I thought he might have jarred him. And hurt his jaw a little bit.
Well, he's on again, and he has the puck again. Gives it to Murphy, who'll give it back to Coffey. Bureau can't stop him. The pass was behind Murphy, though. Duchesne's shot missed on the short side. Recchi back in his own zone. 50 seconds left on the power play. Duchesne put it in for Bureau. Bureau just lobbed it in behind the net, and he is going off. Minnesota changing. Broughton is on with Gavin. Penguins move it out. Casey out of the net quickly. Slapping it away. Was Chambers. And out comes Barrasso.
You can't just shoot the puck in indiscriminately against John Casey. If he gets it, he makes a good move with it, or he shoots it out himself. And that power play shoot-in was a good example of why you can't let him touch the puck.
Minnesota shutting down Pittsburgh. Killing this penalty. Only 10 seconds left in it. Broughton nearly stole it. Tenorti shot it from center ice. And the penalty is over. Nothing happened for Pittsburgh on that power play. Coffey and all. Pass stopped at center by Dahlquist. Moving in with Dahlin. Shoots. Barrasso covered this angle. Made it save. Here's Chambers. He misses by 3 feet. Lemieux going back. Had to knock it on the boards and get it out. And he took a hit. Tenorti back in for Minnesota. Tenorti forced on the outside. And he lost it. Jagr had to come in front of his own net. Smith hit him. Wilkinson coming in from the blue line. Boy, these defensemen jump in the rush in a hurry. They'll go in deep. Coffey can't clear it. Shot in front of the net. Passed up for Lemieux. Nice play ahead. Jagr, good play. Jagr. And he hit the defenseman trying to drill it at the net. Jagr made a pretty move to get in there, though. 2-1 Pittsburgh. 7:30 remaining in the second period. Stanton coming out to the line, and he had to shoot it from there. In wide of the net. No icing. It's been waved off. Adano stopped. Samuelson had him covered. Now Glenn played it up outside the line. Penguins on it again. Once again, Mullen coming in. It's dropped back. Mullen on the boards with it. And he couldn't handle it. Prop took it away from him. At the Pittsburgh line was Stanton. And now Loney near center ice. Coming in. And he is bumped by Jim Johnson. He got back up though. Laid it back to the net for Joey Mullen. Mullen stopped by Glenn. It's centered. Shot right in front of the net, and Casey again makes the save on Loney with Francis in there trying to find it. 6:41 to play in the period. Pittsburgh
leading by the goal. It's time to play the Foodland Hotspot giveaway.
Lateral movement comes across the goal crease and makes the save.
And this time he had to be careful with that shot from the blue line. It was fired right away from the line on the faceoff, and Casey's not up yet.
Well, that was a quick bang-bang play off the draw. John Casey just now getting up. Maybe he's fatigued. I don't know if he got hurt when he got hit. But the shot came in from the point. Jim Pack letting it go, and it ricocheted through, and Casey had to make the save and cover up on the second chance on the rebound from the short side. One thing that the Penguins heard here for the first time since, certainly we've been coming here, Bob, 16,164 here again tonight. They heard some boos during that last power play when they were really standing still. And especially after the power play, when Minnesota had some chances, they were just running around. They couldn't get Coffey off the ice. He was tired. It was a tough moment for them. They survived.
Francis won the draw. Mullen back quickly. Pock, another high shot, but missed the goal. Tenorti takes it. I just stayed out and he saw Mullen there, so he backed up. Bob Erie charging in with a shot, deflected wide. It is centered right in the crease area. Duchesne for the North Stars. For Gavin. Gavin not allowed to go around. Puck played the man all the way. Benardi charging in again. Pittsburgh getting out. Two of them. It is Francis carrying in. Erie going for the net. Francis dropped it back. He might have had the shot himself. Here's a shot. And that into traffic in front of the net. Bounced into the corner. Mullen again moving up. Centered it. Mullen missed it. And Duchesne, realizing Pittsburgh had the pressure on, shot it away.
One thing the North Stars do very well is when they get in trouble, they fall back in front of Casey. And a lot of good chances never get to them as they're blocked.
Again, Barrasso shot it out of the zone. There goes Phil Bork. Looking at as far as the line, but he did not get there in time. Paglianetti back for Pittsburgh. Hawk in the corner, and here's Phil Bork with Lemieux. The center is Recchi. Recchi is stopped at the line by Jim Johnson. 5-10 left to play in the second period. Murphy back, he missed it. Minnesota on and right in front, and again Barrasso had to be good to stop Barazan. Here's Lemieux. The center penalty coming up. Look at Lemieux. Oh my heavens. What a goal. What a move. Lemieux. Times over the next few days. It makes it 3-1 Pittsburgh. Now what a big goal that is for the Penguins. They're in again. Yager's shot missed on the short side. Now they're starting to throw the weight around again. Funny, Harry, how it was so quiet. And now Lemieux took it on himself to get him going. And they're noisy again.
Well, he can be the difference. That's how good he is.
Oh, baby, Casey just saw that one in time. Pittsburgh really coming on after a sluggish 6-7 minutes. It was all Minnesota. Collision at the Pittsburgh blue line. The linesman had to come in quickly.
Ah, the two old-timers, Crotchy and Smith. About 70 years' worth of bones nearly collided there.
15:04 was the time of that magnificent effort by Lemieux from Bork.
Can paint great pictures, but none any better than that one.
Pittsburgh 3, Minnesota 1. 3:50 left in the second period. Still got the bumps in my arm from watching Mario turn everybody inside out. Oh, great. There's Stevens rooting the puck loose. It got back to the blue line. Murphy winds up, throws a rebound, is there! Score!
Around the goal, Murphy shoots it through a crowd.
Goal. He
turned his team around, because these two goals come after they were having just an absolutely dreadful period and were really hanging on.
The time of that goal was 16:32, and Noah Mariel was not in on the scoring play. It was Stevens for Mullen and Murphy.
Mariel was in on it, Bob. He just didn't get an assist.
Okay, Yager up along the board. It's played to the line of Trache through center to Pock. Back again, Erie to Pock. At the side of the net, he's around the goal, trying to jam it in. No, the net was off the magnets. The crowd thought it was in. The puck stayed out.
Well, the Pittsburgh Penguins coaching staff told me they had to crowd Casey and get some big bodies in front of him. He's a little goalie, and if you give him a look at all the shots, he's going to make you look bad. And they did on that fourth goal and nearly got a fifth doing the same thing.
This is turning into blowout time here.
Let's have a look at the goal that isn't counting. Look at the crowd in front of the net. Trotsky's right in his face. Jim Peck comes around the net and shoots it in. The North Star player's got it in his feet. Neil Broughton, but you can see Andy Van Halleman in perfect position, waved it off quickly.
Pittsburgh has taken a pretty good 4-1 lead here in the second.
Well, here's Peck coming out from behind the net, a heads-up play there, and you can see that the puck never went in as it bounced off both Neil Broughton's skates and stayed on the line. Bob Johnson said he prefers confidence over experience in the playoffs. Coaches don't want kamikaze pilots who flew 28 missions. They want someone who can get it right the first time. And he made some interesting lineup changes to get rid of those guys who weren't getting it right, and it looks like it's paid off.
Face off to the right of John Casey. Pittsburgh now out shooting Minnesota 24-23. The big numbers on the board go 4-1 Pens. Minnesota trying to get back into it now. Led by Bellows up the center. Over the line and trying to drive in. He centered it. Harry was back there for Trache. Ahead it goes. Here's Yager. He can't handle it. Now he gets it again. Yager had it knocked off his stick a second time. And the Minnesota player along the boards fell on it. And that stops the play. Harry is stopped by Brian Lynn.
Well, Lynn punched him, but Erie really, and he's known as a diver around the National League, and he's got the penalty. I don't know why he doesn't get up, but he was hit with a glove-on punch, and Brian Glenn lost his poise and takes a penalty with 2:33 left in the second.
Getting acting left.
So, power play for Pittsburgh. And that's Coffey with Murphy. Shot right in front of the net. Hit by Stevens. Stopped by Casey. Stevens has two goals in the hockey game. 2:15 left of the second. 4-1 Pittsburgh. Left wing pass. In around the net. Here comes Murphy charging in from the blue line. Hooked it back. There was Lemieux. And over there for Coffey. Takes the shot. And it hits somebody in front of the net. And it was cleared away by Dahlquist. 1:50 left for the period. 1:10 left for the penalty. Pittsburgh moving it up. Here's Coffey. He got in for Murphy. Great save by Casey.
Well, if the puck hadn't been bouncing, I'm sure Paul Coffey would have taken the shot. But he knew it was bouncing. And rather than risk getting a quarter of the puck, he passed it back. Watch it here. He can't settle the puck down. So he threw it back through to Nordy. And Murphy gets a shot. But John Casey makes a nice stop.
Now here's a look at power play goals in the playoffs with the North Stars setting the record tonight. 33 total. The Bruins at 24. They can't add to their total, but the Penguins can, and they're going to try here with 103 still left in the Glenn penalty. Wonder, Harry, they brought in Coffee, gave a great lift to the crowd and obviously to the team in the final analysis here through the two periods of play anyway. But with the score 4-1, well, this ball wants to play. They got to get him back in shape.
Well, he's been out a long time, and obviously he's lost some weight. He can't feel very good.
He's on there again on this power play as it continues. 1.5 left in the period. Mullen with the puck, going to the boards, around the net. Phil Bork to the blue line. Looks to Coffey. Took it on the backhand. Put a shot in there quickly. Coffey was bumped by Bureau and knocked down. Now Duchesne in with a shot, and that's gloved easily by Barrasso. He decides to play it ahead. Mullen hitting Coffey, who's skating in. Coffey into the corner with it. Phil Bork. Tenorti all over him, and he can't hold on to it. Into the final minute of the period, and 15 seconds left in the power play. Coffey all the way back, had to go by Gavin High. Down the ice. It'll be icing with the North Stars back to pick it up. Dahlquist does, and they'll bring it all the way back.
Well, the Pittsburgh bench got very upset when Mark Bureau took an extra step into Paul Coffey, but I don't think Coffey, the fans, or the Penguins can think that the North Stars for 1 second are going to have any more regard for Paul Coffey's jaw problem than anyone else who might be half hurt out there. It hasn't been a cheap shot. It's been twice now. Guys finished the checks to Paul. The whole Pittsburgh bench stood up and gave Bureau quite an earful as he just took out Mr. Coffey.
40 seconds left of the period. Face off, as you see, inside the Pittsburgh line. And they wrap it down the ice again. As Erie was the first one out there. He plays it well, knocked down behind the net. Loney is in with Erie, trying to come up with it. And they hold it on the boards in the corner. And Hellman says to move it. They try to, and they do. Stanton at the blue line. Other side for Samuelson. His shot blocked. And the North Stars clear of the zone. Coming in is Gagne. Pass it ahead, and Madonna was covered. Samuelson was hit and behind the play. And he is slow getting up, and there's another penalty being called. It is against Minnesota.
Wilkinson and Loney nearly had it going.
Wilkinson's the guy that hit Samuelson, a roughing penalty. Danny Van Helleman gave the punch signal, so Wilkinson goes in with only 2 seconds left in the second period as he knocks Samuelson down. And Bob Gainey's Minnesota North Stars have lost their poise a little bit here. That's the second bad penalty taken in the last 6 or 8 minutes.
You look back to the first period and the change in the intensity of the Penguins and the crowd. Samuelson had a lot to do with that. The way he started out this game, the hit on Bellows, and he looked hairy like the Samuelson we watched through most of the series against the Bruins. He gets nailed here, and then Wilkinson gets nailed by the referee.
Well, it's a great way to start the third period with a power play that's going to be 1:58 long, and you have a 4-1 lead. And the North Stars have pulled some magic off before, obviously, in these 91 playoffs, but I don't know whether they can handle this one.
Well, they started the second period with Minnesota having the man advantage, and they did, in fact, get a power play goal at 55 seconds. And, boy, this period is not done yet. It might be as far as the time is concerned, but they're going to have our first fight in the Stanley Cup Final.
Tenorti and Loney, two big boys. Tenorti's been instructed a lot of this year not to fight. His value as a player has increased to the degree that his coach doesn't want him being involved in this kind of stuff. You know, you can end up with 2, 5, and 10. And the North Stars, any hope of coming back, that a lot of it relies on guys like Tenorti from back on the blue line.
Tenorti trying to get that right hand free, and he does now. But the linesman will be in. To Pittsburgh for period three, and the Penguins start with a power play here in the third period. They're leading 4-1. Jim Johnson
going back to pick it up, took his time and couldn't get it by the man at the blue line. Now Casey rolled it ahead. Coffey is back. Ian Murphy, the defenseman. Recky, Lemieux, and Stevens. Stevens brings it in. Tried to give it to Recky. Coffey made a good move to get up there in a hurry. Played it off the glass into the corner. And it's cleared down the ice. 1:20 left of the penalty now. Coffey back. Skating the other way, and Murphy picks it up. Out to Recky. Recky had to move it quickly to Stevens. Couldn't handle it cleanly. And Duchesne pulls it into the center ice area and then shot it in. Barrazal to skate the puck. Duchesne again. Trying to move in. He's in deep. Couldn't center it by Murphy. Stevens bumping in the corner with Barrazal. Coming in. Lemieux, Coffey. Here's a pass in front, right through the crease. Nobody there. Coffey had moved out. Coffey given a bump by Duchesne. In on the boards. And the North Stars get it out of the zone again. Murphy and Coffey. Coffey's pass tended for Lemieux. He had to skate for it to pick it up. Now Phil Bourne trying to stop Gavin. And does. Minnesota doing a pretty good job right here. Only 20 seconds left to kill in the penalty. Pass to Bellows. Bellows lost it. 10 seconds left. Lemieux again. Shot it from center ice. Casey gloved it. Kept it in behind the net. Now the penalty is over as they shoot it down the ice. And Minnesota at full strength. Pittsburgh, a comfortable 4-1 lead. Going through another harmless power play. Puck over the boards at the penalty box area. And they stop it.
We said at the top of the show that the Pittsburgh Penguin big guns had to get going. Mario Lemieux's got 2 points. Kevin Stevens has got 2 points. And there's Paul Coffey. He handed his helmet. Watch him get hit with an elbow right here by Duchesne. Or the forearm to test the helmet. And when he came to the bench, he handed the helmet to equipment manager Steve Latt to make some kind of an adjustment. Here's Steve behind him, you see, putting a new chin strap on it. So I'm sure it's not a comfortable night for Coffey, but I'm sure he's really enjoying the opportunity to play in this finals and become an asset and help this team win the cup.
Again, Minnesota shooting it down the ice. Barrasso plays it. At the 20-minute mark of the second period, Hero and Tenorti. Roughing and a major for fighting to Tenorti. Loney through a minor and a major. Here's Jagr trying to go in. Touch a shot is kicked away. Score!
No goal.
It's waved off.
I think he's going to rule that Bob Airey was in the crease.
Or the net came off the moorings before the puck went in. I think he's pretty safe, Andy, on this one. As he's going over there, he can call it either way. Let's have a look at it. Jagr makes a nice play here and is hooked at the last second. Now the net's off, but you know the net was pushed off by Brian Glynn with not being hit in there at all. He really should give Glynn a delay of the game penalty and call the goal back, but I don't think he did.
Put his hand up on the crossbar. Made a save, mind you, but indeed knocked the net off. And nearing the 3-minute mark of the third. Stanton trying a long one from Casey. The blocker save was an easy one. Here's a break for Gagne. In front of the net, and a beautiful play by Stanton, reaching out to stop that short pass intended for Prop. Stanton got back and made a great play. Centered again. Again, Prop denied a chance for a shot on the net. There's Prop. Shot it ahead for Gagne, and he lost it. Hot. Lemieux coming in over the drive. AC Black had a rebound there in front for Stevens, but he couldn't get there in time. Prop again for Minnesota. Over the line and got rid of it inside that blue line. Recky turning back. His pass to the far wing. Stevens takes it at center. Coming up with Taglianetti. Taglianetti in the corner, turning around with it. The Penguins were making changes as Bobby Smith picks it up in his own zone. Got it over for McDonald. Up across center, that's offside, onto the stick of Bellows. And they bring that back.
Most of the first half of the season, what a story.
Too much Russian dressing.
That's right, this is another team that went to the Soviet Union.
4 minutes gone in the third period. Minnesota trying to fight back. Bellows takes it. Dolan is in front, but the pass was out of his reach. Stevens up for Mullen. Murphy follows the play. Up for Mullen. He's got the puck back to Stevens. Stevens' high shot off the arm of Casey. Murphy kept it in. Laid it in behind the net. Mullen on the puck. To the side of the goal. Stevens trying to center it. Mullen trying to dig it out. And Minnesota comes up with it. Getting back to center ice, flipping it in was Johnson. Penguins turn it back the other way. Stevens over his stick. Pittsburgh changing now as they come up to the 5 minute mark of the third. 4-1 to score, Pittsburgh. Minnesota shooting it in. Carrasco out of the net. And it's chucked out to center ice, where Brock picked it up. Fired back in. Carrasco coming out. Leaves it behind the net wisely, because that's an icing call against Minnesota. 5-10 gone in the third. Pittsburgh up by 3. Here's Jagr getting in there. And he tried to make the play for Trotsky instead of shooting himself. And it was intercepted. Good play by Jagr, though. Then Jagr back in his own zone now. Put it on the boards. It's kept in by Gagne. And a penalty coming up against Minnesota. As Gagne picked up the puck. I think Ryan Kropp will be the penalized player. Francis hooked it back. All coffee again. And now moving up is Jagr. Goes to the right side to Francis. He was belted at the blue line. Jagr going into the corner. He's taken out of the play. But Francis picks it up and sweeps up front with a pass to Mullen. He missed the open side. Mullen going back to the net. Tenorti will get a chance to clear for Minnesota. He hit Murphy backing up near center ice. Here's Murphy. 1:30 left for the penalty. All the way back. Coffey is skating with it. He's getting to center. Full stride now. Coffey. Hold down before he could get a shot. Coffey doesn't like it. Sliding into the boards. And it cleared all the way back inside the Pittsburgh line.
And he gave us a little taste of that great acceleration that he does better than anybody that plays the game now. And maybe anybody that ever played the game.
Here's Stevens. Skating this time, he can go too. Recky is in with the puck. Recky and Stevens. And here's Coffey. Shot is blocked. Murphy left the point. Nobody back there. Now it's Bureau. He gets in with a drive, and Barrasso covered that. LeBeau back deep in his own zone, sidestepping. A hit maybe from Duchesne. Stevens overskates it. And it's shot in there again with 30 seconds left of the penalty. Lemieux off. Trottier on. 4-1 Pittsburgh. Recky was hit. Stevens going in. Tried to hit the short side with a wrist shot and missed. Minnesota get the puck out. Chasing it is Smail. Gets a skate on it, but the play was offside. 12:41 left in the third period.
Minnesota being quite a little bit more chippy this period, since they're behind 4-1 with a little over 12 minutes to go. And Andy Van Holleman's got a bit of a time bomb on his hands now, as the North Stars are going after the Penguins with great regularity. Gaétan Duchesne tried to see if he could get Mario Lemieux in his sights. Missed him. Let's have a look at that one. Now Mario, he's got those antenna up. He feels these kind of things coming. And you can see that Gaetan went by him in a big hurry.
Well, to kind of change the words of the old song, Harry, I'll give you something to remember me by, because they're going back to their home ice 48 hours from now.
All the great ones have that ability to take that little peek. No matter carrying the puck or not, they see all parts of the ice. Gretzky, Lemieux, Bobby Orr.
And they don't really get hit with many head-on collisions, do they? Maybe that's why they play as long as they do with as few injuries as they've had, although Lemieux had the bad back. It wasn't because he took a rocket body check.
Puck had to hustle back to cover up on a mistake he made in the corner. Losing it. It comes in front of the net. But Artie's blast blocked. Skating away with it is Yager. One man to beat. He has to turn back from it. Now Tenorti is back. Good play for Erie. Trying to get it back to Yager. Puck shot. Nice save by Casey. Yager again. Keeping the heat on. He's back to the goal. And he has that big reach too. Taglianetti moving in deep. Shoved it into the corner and hit the referee. And he has to move quickly to get out of the traffic jam. Holding it is Taglianetti on the boards. Holding it with a skate. Time runs on. 11:40 remaining in the third. Taglianetti. Finally, they decide to call it.
Lanny Van Helleman's a referee that is very reluctant to blow the whistle on pucks held around the board.
It's still 4-1 Pittsburgh. That could be a bit odd. Having lots of fun, though. This crowd is definitely a different crowd with a lead. And they've got one now. 4-1. Nearing the 9-minute mark of the third period, trying to even the series. Kept inside. Minnesota now having a tough time against the checking of the Penguins. Look at this. Near center, Samuelson. Fake the shot. Offside. Called at the blue line. All the trophies, along with the Stanley Cup, on display in the lobby of our hotel here in Pittsburgh. The Westin, William Penn, and a steady parade of Pittsburgh hockey fans and others in to see a fabulous display of silverware. Thousands going through every day. Pittsburgh really caught up into this. So is Minnesota. So we look forward to going north tomorrow for games 3 and 4. 10:30 left in the third period in this one. Rock and the North Stars trying to get something going, but unable to do anything at this moment as Loney goes in with Erie. Boy, Loney shot a high one over the shoulder. Casey flipped up along the boards to center ice. And then tipped back in by Trottier. Halfway mark of the third now. Intercepted again. Recchi couldn't handle it, though. This is Smale moving in. Barrosan's backhander. Lasso down and made the save. And the net again off the magnets. Just as Recchi was about to skate away with it. Our Stanley Cup coverage continues in a moment. Lemieux won the draw. Taglianetti got as far as center and then just banked it off the boards to get it in. Pittsburgh trying to even the series. Best of 7. 5-4 win for Minnesota in game 1. Brian Glynn moving up. Cut off in front of the net. Gets back in and is passed this time and stopped. Through center. Lemieux played it up over the line. Penalty coming up. Minnesota. Two Penguins on the ice. The North Stars get a penalty. Duchesne.
Not the kind of play, Harry, that we heard about from a distance, the way the North Stars were disciplined and all of that, but
With the score 4-1, they've taken a lot of this kind of stuff now. As you referred to a little earlier on, it's chippy. And not much reason for all of that. So at 10:39, and the Penguins get another power play chance. The North Stars continue to take themselves out of any miracle comeback that they may have going for them, or might have had going for them, I guess I should say, as Duchesne gets the hooking penalty to 10:39. I mentioned Brian Bellows playing his 99th game tonight. This was the year Mario didn't play very much in the regular season. This is his 46th game, league and playoff, coming back off the back injury. And tonight, with his 2 points, he now has 80 points in those 46 games.
Got 80 points on the one goal in my book.
Stu Gavin nearly raced in. Behind him is Broughton. Broughton shot, juggled by Barrasso. Now power play Pittsburgh, and they move it out to Yager. He's on with Lemieux and Francis. They go over the line offside as they set up Lemieux, but it was too late.
Jaromir Jagr's line has been changed a little bit. First of all, he's playing some power play time. He didn't do any of that in game one. And remember, he got two assists and was one of the real offensive threats for the Penguins. He's playing with Brian Trotsky, and tonight they've got Bob Erie to give that line a little more speed and maybe open things up for this talented 19-year-old hockey player. Loney was on his line in game one, and offensively, Trotsky, who slowed down as the defensive center, only, and Loney, who's not an offensively skilled player, I don't think helped Jagr at all. And Pittsburgh has to take advantage of the fact that this guy Jagr is a skilled offensive player and maybe give him a little help. A good move by Bob Johnson, who's played three lines for the most part tonight. They only dressed 11 forwards. Gillen has been used only to kill penalties. And so this has been a three-line victory by the looks of it, with 8:58 to go for Bob Johnson's Pittsburgh Penguins.
NHL President John Ziegler in attendance tonight. Popping his pants.
No, he's not dancing tonight. Well, he played. I saw him this morning leave to play golf at 7:15. He may have had a bad round.
I'll do that to you.
Tenorti clears the zone. 1:20 left in the penalty. Coffey on the ice again. And he has the puck now. Coffey. Put it ahead for Murphy, and Jagr comes in with Lemieux. Couldn't reach that pass. Couple of feet in front of him. Here's Berezan. He gets a shot away. That's deflected. Took the heat off that one. It was just off the far side. Recchi shot it in. Here's Stevens moving up. Stevens, two goals on the night for Pittsburgh. And 45 seconds left of the penalty as Coffey breaks up the rush. Got the puck up across center ice. Again, cleared by Johnson. Right in front of the net. Out comes Barrasso to give it to Mullen. Mullen is on the move, but it's Coffey who goes to Stevens. Now to Mullen. That's too far. Mullen giving chase in to pick it up. There's Mullen again. Side of the net with it. Stevens trying to get it back to him, and it's cleared down by Minnesota. Penalty about over. Only 8 seconds left. Roberts to center ice. Roberts again for Samuelson. He's given a light bump by Dolan. And coming back is Glenn. He starts the North Stars out. 7:10 left in the third. Bobby Smith tried to stick handle through. Picked away by Barrasso. Another shot. Smith knocked down in front of the net, and that's going to be a penalty against the Pittsburgh Penguins. And I think it's Trottier or Samuelson.
A veteran referee of many years in the National League.
Going in the Hockey Hall of Fame this year.
With Mr. Bowman.
Right.
There's Tenorti back for Minnesota. Bellows was up there alone, but he was offside. And they bring it back inside the Minnesota line.
Well, Brian Bellows back in action. Good news for the North Stars. He shook off whatever was that ailed him here a little while ago when he left the ice in a lot of pain.
Two guys that have been really unnoticeable tonight for the North Stars, who were really instrumental in their three successful playoff rounds.
Propp and Gagne, they both look tired to me. Gagne especially, who really played some great hockey, has had the puck very rarely, and when he's had it, he hasn't been able to do much with it. And you wonder whether those guys are getting a little tired, because the North Stars played as many tough games as anybody else did to get this far.
Propp was hauled down. Roberts hanging on to the puck to the center ice wall, backhands it in. 1:30 left in the Samuelson penalty. 4-1 Pittsburgh. Brock's long shot. Wipe wide for the rebound. Gagne! And Barrasso stopped that. Brock got it back. Tenorti didn't expect that pass, and he missed it. 1:15 left in the power play. Broughton shoots it in to the left of Barrasso. It's chopped back out again. Gillen clearing it all the way down the ice. 1 minute left for the penalty. Pittsburgh checking well. They line up on the blue line as Barrasso steps behind the net. He likes to shoot it away himself, and does. Gets it out to center. 45 seconds left of that penalty. Minnesota can't get near Barrasso. Fires another one on the glass. Gets it out to Mullen. Gillen was up there. Mullen couldn't get the puck out to him. Turning back is Glynn. Shot it on the glass. It bounced down in front of him. He didn't see it. And it was clear. There's Casey. Way out of the net to play it across center. Taglianetti shot it in over the Minnesota line. 20 seconds left for the penalty. Smith comes to center ice. Pass into Dahlin, drop back. And Barrasso again making a good save. McDonough went right in on top of him. Another save by Barrasso. Out it goes. The penalty is over. 5 minutes left for the third. Here's Trottier. Shoots. Casey the save. Looked very cool, slapping it away. The rebound right in front of him. Mache couldn't stop Madonna. Barrasso stepping up. Taglianetti trying to clear it. It's knocked down at the line. Now Taglianetti moving up. This time he makes sure of it. Gets it out. With 4:30 to play in the third. And Pittsburgh looking to tie this best of seven series before the scene shifts to Minnesota. Barrasso, solid tonight in goal for Pittsburgh. The net gone again. Roberts and Smith bumping. So they call the play with 4:17 to play in the third. Hero won the draw, but Glynn wasn't ready for the swift pass that came back. There's Casey challenging Airy. He hit Airy with the clearing attempt. Pache nearly stole it in front from Berezan. 4 minutes to play in this third period. Barrasso with his eye on it. High over his head. Airy trying to catch up. One man back there. Airy went in with Loney. He didn't know. Loney was up with him. Hero stopped by Trottier. Trottier shot one in high. He goes up. But he was hit by Wilkinson near the Minnesota bench. And that draws the crowd right away. Stevens threw a right hand in there.
Well, that's called close quarters. And finally back Stevens off. He might be going to the penalty box. Looks that way. I don't know. The door's open and they're still hassling along the boards. There was a real thump on the boards when Trottier got nailed. And this is the result. To do with free agent signings and with options and all that.
The list of the possible new owners.
Well, he can make a note. 3:30 left in the third period. And he will have tied the series with Minnesota at a game each. Over the line, offside at the Minnesota line with 3:19 to play. Pittsburgh leading 4-1. This program is copyright. And is strictly for the private use of our viewing audience. Any reproduction, retransmission, distribution, or exhibition in whole or in part without the express written consent of Molson Brewery and the Canadian Broadcasting Corporation is strictly prohibited.
Wonder if Bob Gainey will be questioned, Dick, for changing the lineup after he won a game, inserting two players for two rough, tough players that may have been more value to him in this kind of a game that's been much tougher than was game one. And of course, I'm speaking about Shane Chirla and Basil McCray.
No scoring in this third period yet. Barrasso stops this one. Flicked it up on the boards to the right for Yager. He has to do some fancy footwork to get moving. He is stopped over there. Now comes back. Turns in a corner. And he gets away from everybody, but the play had been called.
Boy, he took a couple of grand slam slashes from Brian Propp. As Yager, when he knows he's got the edge on you, he's got great balance and sticks his arm out, and it's pretty tough to get the puck off this big guy. The youngest player in the National League this year, and I think without doubt and without many disagreeing, he's going to become one of the better players in the National League.
You know, you mentioned that the slashing and so on, the North Stars have been doing a lot of that. Bellows took a pretty good one across the back of the legs here a shift ago, and just like we say, something to remember for game three. But through all of that, Stanton and Gagne get the penalties for roughing and the slashing. The kid goes unreported in the penalty statistics. 2:57 left. All right, Harry, these teams are following familiar patterns. Penguins always losing game one. North Stars always losing game two. And, you know, we looked at the tired hockey team here in Minnesota, but it's funny when you go back to home ice, how the new legs are waiting for you when you arrive in the dressing room.
Boy, and when they get in that Met Center, you think this rink's loud. Wait till you hear that one if you haven't seen a game from Minnesota.
A shot from the blue line by Glenn was knocked down, and that sends Harry in. Harry and Mullen. Pass in there, a little bit too far for Gillen. He stops it at center. Lifts a high one into the Minnesota zone. Cleared out. And across center ice. This is Dolan trying to move in. He's taken down, and there's going to be another penalty. Barrasso covering up. Keeps the puck out. But a penalty called here with 2:26 left.
I think Gordy Roberts is going to get it for tackling off Dolan along the boards. I'm not sure of that, but I'm fairly certain Ben Hel- Whoa, and then Gordy Roberts spears.
And Kevin Collins saw it. Yeah. The referee had turned and gone the other way to the penalty box, but Kevin Collins saw it.
Gordy Roberts spears Johnson, I guess it is, or is it McDonald? Or Glenn, and number Glenn. Six, Glenn. And that'll be gone for Mr. Roberts. There's no minor penalty for spearing. It's five in a game. So he's going to get two for tackling and five for spearing.
Talk about losing cool.
2:26 to go now. The North Stars, if they could ever get one quick one, could take a run here at Pittsburgh when it looked like the game was all but over. So Gordy's gone. Gordy Roberts is gone for 5 minutes.
Number 28, Gordy Roberts, 2 minutes for holding, five minutes for spearing, and a game misconduct at 17:34. Roberts, two for holding, five for spearing, and a game misconduct at 17:34.
And all very obvious in that order. You mentioned that crowd in Minnesota. I was there once this past season, Harry. Middle of January, there were 6,500 people in the building, and the North Stars lost 5-1. What you're telling me is it'll be a different atmosphere. Show up there at
time. All right, have any barbecues outside this time.
I'm going to stop and get you a bratwurst. No.
Watch the left of the frame. Glenn, there's the stick. There's Roberts with the stick. And as you say, Collins was right there. He just turns. Now he's looking at Van Helleman saying, hey, this guy's gone.
You know, Bob Johnson, I'm sure, will talk to Gordy Roberts about that.
Harry, give us a little preview on the tailgating.
All right, you and I are going to walk over from our hotel. They're going to be
hour before
the fishing season is open. They'll be barbecuing some fish. They'll have some bratwurst. They'll might have the odd Molson's Golden. We know they can't have Molson's Canadian down there, but they'll have Molson's Golden.
Sounds like you've been there.
Yes, I have. And on the way back, the Molson's Golden will be all gone, and it'll be a much rougher walk for you and I to get to our hotel.
Were you ever late for a game?
No, you always made it in time.
I leave early for those picnics.
I see. All right.
They come from all over the state.
And it's a weekend game, of course.
Parties, barbecues. Oh, it's going to be a fun time.
Right. And the rink is really hopping. A very young, enthusiastic crowd, and inspires this North Star team to playing a much more aggressive offensively there than they do when they go on the road. And you can see here that they're a dangerous team offensively, but they seem to have a little degree of conservatism that you will not see in the Mets Center.
They're 19-2-2 at this moment going home.
And many times blow teams right out of there. They beat Edmonton badly twice in the Mets Center.
Bellows, a last gasp, trying to go in and get something going from an offensive point of view. Mullen hauled down, can't get going on the loose puck. Tenorti turned back. 2 minutes left in the third period. The Penguins have satisfied their crowd tonight. Here comes Casey to the bench. Empty net back there. And he's centered in front. And Barrasso didn't get a chance to make the save. Azuri stopped it. This will miss the empty net. 1:44 left. 4-1 Pittsburgh. Minnesota. Don't give up. Still trying to do something. Here he intercepting another pass. And the puck over the glass at the far side. That stops the play with 1 minute and 32 seconds left to play in the third period. The shots, 36-31 in favor of Minnesota at this point.
And 6-4
for Minnesota at this point.
Well, I thought in game one of the advantages that was most obvious that the North Stars had over the Penguins was they looked like they worked a lot harder than they did. And Bob Johnson said, coming into tonight, he says, we were beating the loose pucks all night in game one, and until we get our share of those one-on-one battles for the puck, any strategic changes in our plan aren't worth much. And they certainly have not been outworked tonight. They've been the superior team, and this series is going to get better as it goes on. We move on to Minneapolis-St. Paul.
Nothing loose about the puck Mario had at 15-minute mark of the second period when he turned everybody inside out and scored to make it 3-1 at that point. That dulled the North Star. Long shot, Barrasso save. He's been solid tonight in goal for the Penguins. Empty net down there, and they shoot it away, and Urbino icing. 1:15 left in the third period. Gillen in forechecking. The North Stars move it out. Up to center. Lynn knocked one in behind the net. Barrasso out. 1 minute left. Third period. Here's Smith for Minnesota. Tries the short side. Stopped by Barrasso. Smith again. Pass back. Smith winds up. Shoots. Barrasso the save, another shot. He knocked that away. 45 seconds to play. Smith again. For Broughton, his shot picked up by Barrasso. Solid performance by John Barrasso at the net. But away wide again. Now they're standing up at the Civic Arena with 25 seconds to play. Modano shot off the goalpost. And the play stopped. Now they'll get on their feet. Listen to this.
Atmosphere in this city has really been something. It's the thing to do now for television stations to send sportscasters to sporting events and report 6 o'clock news and all that. They sent their whole news teams to the Pittsburgh Arena this past week. The anchor people were here doing the newscast. They were doing all kinds of radio shows and everything. Look at this with the shark hats that they're selling. They could make a deal on those and ship them off to San Jose and get some of the money back for next season. So it's very interesting to see how it's just captured the whole city. Let's go Pens banners hanging from lamp posts and store windows and across buildings. Now Minnesota gets a bench minor penalty, and Andy's upset.
He put his hand up and they kept changing. And now we have all three teams upset with each other now, as the striped official team upset at Bob Gainey's tactic of not paying any attention to Andy Van Helleman, who put his hand up to say no more changes. So the North Stars, who are out of this one anyway, are having a little sit-in here at the bench to demonstrate that they're not too happy with Andy Van Helleman. But I don't think they complained. They had four power plays in a row in the first period. They could have blown the game wide open then and didn't.
Just the reverse of the other night. Pittsburgh had the power play chances that didn't cash in.
So Pittsburgh tying the series at a game each. And I'm going to let the crowd finish this one for you. Pittsburgh Penguins defeating the Minnesota North Stars 4-1 tonight, and they now head north to Minnesota for games 3 and 4. This series is tied.